Okay. There she is.
Hi, Lindsay.
Well, hey, Lindsay. There you are. Nice to see you again. Hi. All right. Well, welcome, everyone. Shabbat shalom. It's so nice Shabbat to see shalom. Everyone. Shalom. Everyone hear me okay? I'll make sure
yes.
my microphone
yes.
is. Yeah, perfect. I can hear you this time. That's great. So welcome back. Lindsay and I were delighted to have this opportunity again. It's always fun to craft a service together, and it's fun to lead the service, and we're excited to be here. A couple housekeeping things. One, Lindsay has already alluded to a little bit, but for anyone who's maybe just logged on, we're going to recommend that the best viewing experience for you is going to be the side-by-side in most cases, which means that we will be screen sharing. I am already screen sharing, correct? So you'll see slide on one side, and if you're in speaker view, this is actually reminding me of my second piece of housekeeping, which is, could everyone please mute themselves through the service? Because I can't tell exactly, when I can't see everyone, when people speak, I can't exactly tell who's speaking.
I want to recommend you mute everyone.
Right. So I'm going to ask everyone to mute themselves and just be mindful throughout the service, especially, barking dogs, ringing telephones and things like that, that if you do unmute, we will, obviously hear you. So please do remain muted unless you have a live part in the service. You should feel free at that point to unmute yourself. You'll have to unmute yourself to participate. So again, back to the viewing 50-50. So if you stick in speaker view, and you should have like a 50-50 where your screen is split somewhat down the middle where you see both the slides and the speaker. And again, there's a vertical line in most cases that you can drag to the left or to the right to make either the slides or the speaker bigger or smaller as you wish. So if you want to zoom into something, that's how you'd likely do it. And finally, this is being recorded, although I don't see that I'm recording. So it is being recorded. So with that, Lindsay.
All right. Yes, so Shabbat Shalom. So we're going to start with an opening song, the title of which is called We Return. The actual title of it is Hashivenu, which literally translates to, I think, turn us back from what I was reading. These lyrics sort of interpreted as we return. And you'll hear in the song the ideas of returning to love, truth, and to you, which in this case is referring to God. And so on this Shabbat, we invite you to think about what are you returning to or turning back to? What are you willing to try and get closer to as we spend this time together and celebrate Shabbat thinking about that? So we invite you to sing along.
We return.
Tovu Ahalacha Yaakov, Mishkanotecha Israel. How fair are your tents, O Jacob, your dwellings, O Israel? How many times we've recited these words and how different their meaning is given our present reality. The reverence they express is no longer limited to a physical place, our beloved house of worship with its awe-inspiring sanctuary, but extends now to describe virtual tents, in some ways more accessible than ever before. According to Numbers 24:5, from which this prayer's opening line derives, Balaam had intended to curse the Israelites, but instead, overcome with awe at God and the Israelites' house of worship, winds up blessing them. How fair are your tents, O Jacob? If we are heartened during this time by nothing else, perhaps we should take solace in the notion that some curses wind up blessings despite themselves. Today, we are blessed with the wideness of our virtual tent.
Mama, 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 mama Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, sovereign of the universe. With divine wisdom, you have made our bodies, combining veins, arteries, and vital organs into a finely balanced network. Wondrous maker and sustainer of life, were one of them to fail, how well we are aware we would lack the strength to stand before you. Blessed are you, Adonai, source of our health and strength. Baruch atah Adonai. Rofe call the sore, umafli lasso.
We turn now to the prayer of Elohai Nishama. Nishama, one of the Hebrew words for breath, also means soul. The sages of the Talmud suggest that upon awakening in the morning, a person should say, Elohai Nishama shenatata bi tehora. My God, the soul that you have placed within me is pure. Breathing, the natural rhythm of expanding and condensing, occurs not just with the air sacs of the lungs, but throughout the body, each cell gently expanding and condensing as it receives oxygen and nourishment and releases what is no longer needed. The ubiquitous process of breathing, of receiving oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide, defines life itself. Rabbi Diane Elliott writes, "Each morning as I draw my first conscious breaths of the day, I am transported back to the state of purity and wonder that our tradition ascribes to the first human, breathed into aliveness by the infinite, reminding myself that each soul breath I inhale from the source is tehora, or pure, becomes a touchstone for my day. Whatever challenges greet me, whatever missteps I take, I can return again and again to the gift of pure breath, soul that remains unsullied, unshaken by the vicissitudes of the moment, refreshed, awakened, and fully alive."
Elohai, 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 Eloh
I will admit that before partnering with Lindsay to help craft lay-led services, I was more of a Kabbalat Shabbat or Friday evening server person myself. That being the case, Nisim Bechol Yom, a reading for daily miracles. Nisim, by the way, we might know as the plural of a word, or rather a word we know better, Nes, from Hanukkah, from the dreidel Nes, Gadol HaYashah, or Po. So for daily miracles is not a blessing I'm well acquainted with for that reason. While it makes good sense to me to articulate gratitude for life's many blessings, I struggle with some of the items in the accreted list. For example, are the captive necessarily freed, the naked necessarily clothed, the weary necessarily fortified? Do our words serve as the articulation of a thank you to God or of an ideal? Similarly, how do we praise God for having made us Jews without feeling stung by our own particularism? My challenge to you in reciting the next verses is to consider your own interpretation of them. If you were to write your own verses thanking God for daily miracles, what would you include?
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lasek divina lehachvin ben yom uvein laila.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam pokeach ivrim.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam matir asarim.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam. So Kate Kifufi.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Rokah Haaretz Al Hamayim.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Hamechin Mitzadei Gaver.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Malbish Arumim.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, hanotein le'yaeif koach.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, hama'avir sheina me'inai, u'tnuma me'ahapai.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, she'asani b'tzelem Elohim.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, She'asani bat korim.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam She'asani Yisrael.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Ozer Yisrael begvurah.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Oter Yisrael betivara.
Amen. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kedeshanu b'mitzvotav, itzivanu la'asot b'divrei Torah. Amen.
I find by experience, not by reasoning, but by my own discovery that God is near me, and I can be near God at all times. I cannot explain it, but I am as sure of my experience as I am of the fact that I live and love. I cannot explain how I come to live and love, but I know that I do. In the same way, I know I am in contact with God.
I just wanted to jump back and share that those drawings were done by our seventh graders who studied the blessings. And so those were their visual interpretations of them. We now move to the words of Psalm 150. Psalm 150 is the 150th and final psalm in the Book of Psalms. In Psalm 150, the psalmist urges the congregation to praise God with music and dancing, naming 9 types of musical instruments. For this reason, it's also called the musician's psalm. According to Kabbalah, the 10 expressions of praise in this psalm correspond to 10 sefirot, or divine emanations. And if you're like me and you aren't familiar with this, I looked it up and it's actually interesting, but I'll just quickly tell you that these are attributes through which God is thought to show God's self, such as wisdom, understanding, and kindness. In addition, the word halal can be found 13 times in the psalm, correlating to the 13 attributes of mercy, which are listed in the books of Exodus and are the ways that God is thought to have governed the world. The directive hallelujah, or you praise, is seen 12 times, corresponding with the 12 new moons that occurs in the Hebrew calendar year. Psalm 150 then names 9 times of instruments to be used to praise God. While the exact translations of some of these instruments is unknown, Jewish commentators have identified the shofar, the lyre, the harp, the drum, the organ, the flute, the cymbal, and the trumpet. Finally, in verse 6, according to Midrash, the Hebrew words kol haneshama, which literally means let all souls praise God, can also be vowelized as kol haneshama, let every breath praise God. And the Midrash expounds, for each and every breath a person takes, he or she must praise God. Now join Elise in the singing of Psalm 150.
Kol haneshama tehalleluya, alleluya. Kol haneshama tehalleluya, alleluya. Alleluia b'kodesho, alleluia b'kiyahuzo, alleluia b'gvurotav, alleluia k'rov gudlo. Kol haneshama te'alleluia, alleluia. Kol haneshama te'alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia b'teka shofar, alleluia b'nevel v'chinor, alleluia b'tofu machol, alleluia b'minim v'ugav. Kol haneshama te'alleluia, alleluia. Kol haneshama te'alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia b'tzilzalei shama, alleluia b'tzilzalei trua. Kol haneshama te'alleluia, alleluia. Kol haneshama te'alleluia, alleluia. Kol haneshama te'alleluia, alleluia.
Yikara v'yikara shmei rabba, ve'am la yira yirute, ve'am lid mahute, ve'hayeho uv'yomeho, uv'ayedecho v'yit v'Yisrael, ba'gala, ba'gala, uvisman kariv, ve'imeru amen. Yehesh me'rava mevora, le'olam u'le'lam ve'omaya. Yitbarach, yitkadash, v'yitavar, v'yitolah, v'yitaseh, v'yit hadav, v'yit halev, v'yit halah, shmei kudisha, v'rehu, le'am. Vishirata Tushvihata Manemanta Darim Rovilma Vimeru Amen.
Please now rise if it is your custom for the Baruch Hu, our call to prayer.
Baruch Atah Adonai, Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Yotzeh Or Vorei Hoshech, Osei Shalom Vorei Et Hakol. Hamir La'aretz V'Lagalim Aleha Berachem, Uvtuvo Mechadesh B'chol Yom Tamid Ma'aseh Bereishit. Ma'arabu Ma'asecha Adonai, Kulam B'chochma Asita, Ma'a Ha'aretz Kininecha. Tizbarach Adonai Eloheinu al shevach ma'aseh yadeha ve'al ne'ore or she'asita yifalucha sela. Or hadash at Zion ta'ir b'nizkei chulanu mehera ve'o. Baruch ata Adonai yotzer hama'orot.
We now turn to the prayer Ahava Rabbah, and if you were with us last time, you may remember my rather long-winded compare and contrast between Ahava Rabbah and its companion prayer Ahava Olam, and why we say one at night and one in the morning. So this time, I thought I'd do a deeper dive into the debate between the two presidents during that Babylonian Talmudic Academy. Just kidding. I think I just saw my grandfather close his eyes. Instead, my remarks today are simple. This prayer is an expression of love and thanks for the love God has given his people, or God's people. It thanks God for the gift of the Torah, which provides life for making the Jewish people the chosen nation. This prayer contains multiple requests to God, one of them to be enlightened with the Torah. Another is for God to protect us from shame. It is stated that those who cleave to the life of mitzvot will not be shamed. And another is that the Jewish people will be gathered from the four corners of the world and return to Israel. Please pray with us with the words of Ahava Rabbah.
Ah,
Shema and her blessings, we praise God alternately as creator, revealer, and redeemer. Yotzer Or speaks to God's creating the world, Ahava Rabbah to God's revealing Torah to the Jewish people. Micha Mocha recalls God's powers of redemption by recounting the Exodus from Egypt. We sing now a portion of the so-called Song of the Sea, or Shirat Hayam, asking, "Who is like you, O God?"
Yalla la la ya la 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 yalla la 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 yalla la 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 ya la 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 yalla la la ya la 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 la
We now turn to the words of the Amida, or the central core part of our prayer service.
Adonai Sabbatai Tita Ufi Yakin Tila Teha. Adonai, open up my lips, that my mouth may declare your praise.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Elohei Avotinu Imoteinu Elohei Avraham Elohei Yitzhak Elohei Yaakov Elohei Sarah Elohei Rivka Elohei Rahel Elohei Leah Ha'el Hagadol Hagibar Anorah El Elyon, Gomer Hasadim Tovim, Vekoneh Hakol, Vezoker Hasdei Avot V'Imahot, Umevi Geula, Livnei V'Nehem, Leman Shemo Be'ahava, Melech Ozer U'Mashiach U'Magen, Baruch Atah Adonai, Magen Avraham, Bezrat Sarah.
Tagibor Le'olam Adonai, Mehaye Hako Atah, Rav Le'oshia, Meshiv Haruah, U'Magrid Hagashem, Mechalchel Hayim Behesed, Mechaye hako berachamim rabim, so mech nofim verafe holim, uratirashirim, mechaye emunato, lishane afar, mechamo habaal giverot, umitamela, melech memit, umachaye, umatmiye yeshua. V'ne'eman atah l'chachayot hakol, Baruch atah Adonai, mechaye hakol.
Kedusha, sung here as the third part of the Amidah, where it is perhaps best known, is also found in a couple other places in more extended prayer services. Its name derives from the Hebrew word kodesh, which many of us know as holiness. In fact, the kuf dalet shin root is also used in Torah to mean set apartness. The prayer, therefore, describes God's holiness and set apartness. All three recitations of Kiddushah, that is, whether found in the Amidah or elsewhere, have in common verses from Isaiah, Ezekiel, and Psalms, including the instantly recognizable Kadosh, 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 or Holy, Holy, Holy. So good, we say it three times. Not only that, in this prayer, during which recitation we imagine we are God's angels, we We bow side to side, then go up on our toes as if trying to reach heaven. Though the words of Kedusha may not feel that distinct from others in the liturgy, its unique choreography certainly helps set it apart, apropos for a prayer with Kodesh as its root.
We now turn to the words of Vishamru. The prayer is actually a quotation from the book of Exodus. The children of Israel will keep the Sabbath, observing the Sabbath in every generation as an everlasting covenant. It is a sign between God and the children of Israel forever. For in 6 days God made the heavens and earth, but on the seventh day God ceased work and refreshed God's self. It comes from Exodus 31. Reading this in the context of a Shabbat service, we remind ourselves why we continue this ancient practice. We keep it because our ancestors were commanded to keep it. We keep it because it is our custom as a people. We keep it in remembrance of our unique creation story. We keep it because it keeps us. We have many different ways of keeping it, but when we do, our lives are fuller.
Shabbat, Maaseh.
Amidah, also called Tefillat HaAmidah, the standing prayer, or simply HaTefillah, so important it's just the prayer, has yet another name, Shemona Esrei, which literally means 18. Those who are familiar with the prayer might know that it actually has 19 blessings, not 18. I'll refer those who seek an explanation to Rabbi Lawrence A. Hoffman's How the Amidah Began, a Jewish detective story in My People's Prayer Book, a really compelling read. In any event, these 19 blessings fall broadly into three categories: praise, first three blessings, including avot and givurot; request, middle 13 blessings; and gratitude, final three blessings. Hoda'ah, etymologically related to the word todah, meaning thanks, comprises blessing 18, the centerpiece of the final section of the Amidah.
For the expanding grandeur of creation, worlds known and unknown, galaxies beyond galaxies, filling us with awe in challenging our imaginations.
For this fragile planet Earth, its times and tides, and its sunsets and seasons.
For the joy of human life, its wonders and surprises, its hopes and achievements.
For a human community, our common past and future hope, our oneness transcending all separations, our capacity to work for peace and justice in the midst of hostility and oppression.
For high hopes and noble causes, for faith without fanaticism, for understanding of views not shared.
For all who have labored and suffered for a fairer world, who have lived so that others might live in dignity and freedom.
For human liberties and sacred rights, for opportunities to change and grow, to affirm and choose.
We pray that we may live not by our fears, but by our hopes, not by our words, but by our deeds. Blessed are you, Adonai, your name is goodness, and you are worthy of thanksgiving. Baruch Ata Adonai, Atov Shimcha Ulcha Na'eh Lahadot.
And we give thanks to our fifth grade class for having put that together for us. We now turn to the words to offer a prayer for peace of Sim Shalom.
Thank you.
Please take a few moments for silent prayer.
Find love, may we find love. may we find love. Amen. 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 Amen.
At this time in our service, our thoughts turn to those who are in need of healing. We ask the Holy One to grant them a full and speedy recovery and to comfort them and those that are their caregivers. I will read a list of names, but I also invite you to add names into the chat box, which I'll read at the conclusion of the initial list. At this time, we think of Thomas DiMatteo, Mark Friedman, Elizabeth Friedman, Shana Esther Ruchel, Chris Sora, Joel Shemaskin, Chaya Neha, Riva Leia. Hang on one second. So my grandfather that was unmuted. Simon Breitman, Barbara Breyer, Katriel Parachia, Ben Herschel, Lazar Vishoshana, Sally Graff, Saraba Abraham Vissara, William Fawcett Jr., Alan Skirker, Chaim Betsara, Dina Yeshua, Laura Braun, Shulamit Buzo, Raymond Condon, Susan Stilton Tobias, Pamela LeBlot Blackwell, Sandra Vallet, Lori Friedman, Barbara DiCario, Eric Weiner, Marie Eichner, Kim Stanger Delisle, Grace Hughes, Jack Hughes, Yaffa Sarah Bot, Miriam Utsvi, Tudy Driscoll, Ralph Bookbinder, Leona Johnson, Eileen Kaplan, Patrick Doherty, Miriam Baella, Randy Weiss, Eli Washler Felder, Lynn Fragan, Barb Snyderman, Yoni Fine, Stephen Brent, Monica Skirker, Herb Skirker, William Shemesh, Abigail Devora, Bat Bracha, Arya Bar-El. I'm gonna look at the chat. We also add Ryan Potter, Esta Grohlman, Gail and Peter Weinstein, Jonathan Rosenzweig, Amy Peck, Gaspar, Patrick Tarraconi, Lance Bolkel, my apologies, David Attobelli, Tom Peters, Ruth Goldberg, Chloe Orbeck, Harvey Nathan, Gloria Schachter, Baby Emma Gaspar, Leslie Frank, Patty Newman, Marcia Sharfman, Paul Lebowitz, Kirby Lowenstein, Ruth Rosenberg, and Myron Zuckerman. We now join together. Typically, we sing at this time Mishra Berach, and we decided to sing a slight variation of this titled El Na Rafan Allah.
Of peace.
now we get to start our Torah service. We were so honored the last two lay-led services to have Nancy Kraus chant Torah, and we're equally honored today to have Pauline Rosenberg chant. I now call Sharon and Shai Shafir for the honor of the Aliyah.
ברוך אתה אדוני ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר בחר בנו מכל העמים ונתן לנו את תורתו ברוך אתה אדוני נותן התורה
אמן
היי אומר אדוני אל אברהם לך לך מארצך וממולדתך ומבית אביך אל הארץ אשר אראך ואעשה לגוי גדול ואברכך ואגדל לשמך והיה ברכה ואברכה מברכך ומקללך האור ונברכה בך כל משפחות האדמה וילך אברהם כאשר דיבר אליו אדוני וילך איתו לוט ואברהם בן 5 שנים ו70 שנה בצאתו מחרן. ויקח אברהם את שרי אשתו, ואת לוט בן אחיו, ואת כל רכושם אשר רכשו, ואת הנפש אשר עשו בחרן ויצאו. ללכת ארצה כנען, היבואו ארצה כנען. ויעבור אברהם בארץ עד מקום שכם, עד אלון מורה, והכנעני אז בארץ. וירא אדוני אל אברהם, ויאמר, לזרעך אתן את הארץ הזאת, ויבן שם מזבח לאדוני הנראה אליו. ויעתק משם הרב מקדם לבית אל ויית אוהלו, בית אל מים והעי מקדם, ויבן שם מזבח לאדוני, ויקרא בשם אדוני. וישא אברהם הלוך ונסוע הנגבה.
ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר נתן לנו תורת אמת וחיי עולם נטע בתוכנו. ברוך אתה אדוני נותן התורה.
אמן.
Thank you, Pauline, for that beautiful chanting. Can I be heard? Sorry, oops. Hold on, I need to be in the spotlight. Just kidding. Lindsay needs to be in the spotlight. I think I was just so enthusiastic about Pauline's beautiful chanting that I just felt compelled to jump right in. Sorry, Lindsay, go ahead. Please thank her.
Thanks, Pauline. Thank you, Susan. We are now honored to have Joyce Herman provide commentary on this week's Torah portion.
I keep hearing Debbie Friedman's beautiful song that's based on this week's Parsha playing in my head. Lech Lecha, going forth to a place you do not know and being blessed. And being a blessing struck me as a powerful, potentially hopeful message for this tender and dangerous time. Tender and dangerous, given that we are in the midst of a pandemic, climate crises, and an election of greater consequence than any in memory, with an unknown outcome and aftermath. Doesn't it seem that we're living through events of biblical proportions, with millions suffering and dying from disease, famine, war, pharaohs coming to power all over the globe, our precious earth crying out from so much abuse, and our democracy being torn apart bit by bit. Amidst all that, COVID-19 makes us fear being close to other human beings, denying our basic physical, social, and emotional needs for human contact, so essential to our sense of wholeness and to our resilience. Despite all that, let's also notice that this time is illuminating what might be possible in a world we long for. A world more just, more soul-satisfying, where we are connected to one another, to the earth, and to something larger. Let's take a deep, slow breath right now and notice all these precious faces that are here with us this morning. And we've had glimpses of new ways of being in that world. The Black Lives Matter movement, young people's brilliant leadership and movements to heal the earth, blue skies replacing smog, and ironically, the pandemic's dramatic reminder of how interconnected and necessary we all are to one another. God promises Abram, I will make your name great, but he must go to a land you do not know, putting Abram on the threshold of something unknown, very new, and supremely significant. Threshold is that in-between space, that crossing over place from the known to the unknown, like birth or death, and it can be profound, potentially dangerous, potentially glorious. Like this moment, where the only thing certain is uncertainty. Wise voices remind us that this time of great uncertainties that throws us so out of balance can, for some, be a time for spiritual development or for a deep questioning of how our society supports or squashes our most cherished values. And if we allow our grief and fears to surface, significant personal healing can happen. Doing so with supportive friends and loved ones, even if only by phone or Zoom, can be important and cleansing and essential for our ongoing well-being. Rather than a time of waiting to go back to normal, this can be a time for honestly assessing both who we want to be and what kind of world we want. In Rabbi Till's Musar class, we examined which of our 18 soul traits, as in gratitude, humility, generosity, patience, we might work on. And since personal transformation paves a way for society to transform, we heal ourselves to heal the world. Tikkun Olam. As we journey to our unknown, what can we learn from Abraham's journey? It began with listening with awe to a voice calling him to a higher mission. Then with generosity, offering his nephew Lot the choice of the lands laid out before them. With acting on behalf of justice against those who had a war and unjustly grabbed the bounty and the people. With refusing the spoils of victory for himself and making sure they were evenly distributed. With building a new altar when he came to a new place, creating a place to communicate with God and a tangible sign of awe, devotion, and gratitude. Abraham, like other biblical leaders, like all of us, has his flaws. He convinced his wife to say she was his sister, in essence offering her to Pharaoh in order to save his own life, not his only act of patriarchal male supremacy. God disapproved that transaction and punished Pharaoh, not Abram, and continued the plan for Abram, including a covenant with him, renamed Abraham, to raise up and benefit humankind. Abram couldn't know his journey would lead to a new human consciousness, ultimately the consciousness of oneness. The next weeks and months are likely to push us into new territory, perhaps in terms of the pandemic, perhaps in terms of climate emergency, probably in terms of our democracy. As we cross whatever threshold, can we summon the courage to stand up to a system based on protecting and profiting those who have already had the most and hurting all the rest, especially those most in need? A system which does appear to be collapsing. Can we look unflinchingly at the way that we who are considered white have been set up by the society to feel superior to, better than, more deserving than Black people, Indigenous people, and other people of color? Are we really willing to shake up that status quo for the greater benefit of all, as Abraham's embracing of one God did? Can we be guided by Abraham's traits of listening, fairness, justice, gratitude, generosity, and the courage to embrace something way larger than the life he knew? Abraham stayed connected with his God and with his people. Whatever happens next, I believe our security lies in our relationships. That means staying connected with God, if that is our practice, and with as wide and diverse as possible a group of people we care about and who care about us. May we go forth in this potentially dangerous, potentially glorious time, holding in our minds and hearts that we can be a blessing now and for the future. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Joyce, for those thoughtful words. And as Joyce referenced in the beginning, what better or more appropriate song or follow-up to have than the singing of Lechi Lach. And so for that, we welcome Elise.
Lechi Lach, to a land that I will show you. Lech Lecha, to a place you do not know. Lechi Lach, on your journey I will bless you. And you shall be a blessing. You shall be a blessing. You shall be a blessing. Lechi Lach. Lechi Lach. And I shall make your name great. Lech Lecha. And all shall praise your name. Lechi Lach, to the place that I will show you. L'simchat Chaim. L'simchat Chaim. L'simchat Chaim. Lechi Lach. You shall be a blessing. You shall be a blessing. You shall be a blessing. Lechi Lach.
Me, yeah. That was beautiful, Elise. Thank you so much. And if we didn't know it before, we may have guessed from my advancing the slide a little bit too soon that we are now up to the Aleinu. So please rise if you so desire for Aleinu.
The Shabbat sisters reading a thoughtful translation of the prayer Aleinu.
It is upon us to praise the sovereign of the universe and proclaim the greatness of the Creator, who has set us among the other families of the earth, giving us the opportunity to see the world through Jewish eyes.
Let the time not be distant, O God, when all shall turn to you in love, when all the brokenness in the world is repaired by the work of our hands and our hearts, inspired by your words of Torah.
Oh, may all created in your image become one in spirit and one in friendship, forever united in your service. Therefore, we bow in awe
and thanksgiving before the one
who is sovereign over all, the Holy
One of blessing.
Benehemar Behaya Adonai Lemelech al kol ha'aretz Hayom ha'hu, hayom ha'hu, yeh Adonai echad. Ushmo
We think of our loved ones whom death has recently taken from us, those who died at the season in years past, and those whom we have drawn into our hearts with our own. Zichronam livracha, may their memories be for blessing. I am going to read some lists, and of course you are welcome and invited to type in names into the chat box. I shall read those names after I conclude these lists. And here we go. Today we mourn the recent deaths of Dennis Dreyer, father of Rebecca Dreyer, Zarina Wolitsky, mother of Laura Wolitsky, Jacob Handelman, brother of Alan Handelman, Hope Mann, mother of B.J. Mann, Moise Rabinovich, father of Joseph Rabinovich, Suzanne Kramer, Temple Sinai member, Bima Diltz, son of Wahyu Diltz. We also mark the yard sites, the anniversaries of passing of Sidney Albaum, Jean Burko, Harry Blum, Ruth Brooks Helfand, May Buckman, Jenny A. DiGiovanni, Blanche Edison, Louis H. Feldsot, Arlene Foreman, Susie Fox, Alice Geiger, Anna Goldman, Nellie Gross, Charles Grossman, Morton Hare, Sina Hoffman, Mary Israel, Edith Kahn, Jacob Katz, Ralph Katz, Lois Koff, Oscar J. Krasner, Manuel Lederman, Fania Lemberskaya, Lester Levin, Lorraine Litt, Noam Lubchansky, Elaine Marblestone, Leslie Marcus, Beatrice Rose, Ray Rubel, Bessie Shackett, Theodore Silverstein, Laura Scully, Joseph Spector, Jan Stamm, Phyllis Stoltz, Samuel Hyman Steinberg, Natalie Evelyn Teagarden, and Janice Whiteman. Let me check the chat box here, make sure I additional name, Anna Silbert Kessler. And with those people in mind, I now recite. Let me get rid of my chat box so I can read it. Yit Gadal v'yit Kadash Shemei Rabbah. Bama divrach yoti vimich machute, Bahayachon of Yomachon, Ufre de Holbeit Israel, Bagala of Isman, Kari Vimru. Amen. Advance. Yehe Shme Rabba Mivarach, Elam Ome Almaya. Yiparach Vishtabach, Viet Baar, Viet Raman, Viet Nase, Vietadar, Vietale, Vietalal, Shemed Kudshabri Hu, Laelamin Kolberhata Vishirata. Tushbechata v'nechemata, damiran, belma, v'imru, amen. Yehei shlama rabba min shemaya, v'chayim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. Osei shalom b'imramav, hu ya'asei shalom, aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol yoshvei tevel, v'imru, amen.
And now, before we move into our motzi and kiddush and concluding prayers, we have a few brief announcements. So just some highlights on the calendar. Tomorrow we have religious school at 9:30. Tuesday is election day. Vote, everyone. Wednesday we have religious school at 4:30 and Cantor Braun's Introduction to Trope class at 7 p.m. Friday, November 6th, we have Erev Shabbat services with sermon and song and birthday blessings. Saturday, November 7th, we have Torah and Shabbat morning services. I just lost the rest. Oh, nope, that's not the rest of my note. Here we go. Remember that early voting continues until November 1st, which is tomorrow. You can vote early at any voting location. I myself did it at Harris Whalen just the other day. Took maybe 10 minutes. Absentee ballots can be mailed, dropped off at any early voting location or at the Board of Elections. On election day, absentee ballots can be dropped off at your polling location or the Board of Elections. Please join us for a special Hanukkah project, Sinai Sings. Myself and Kira Braun are working on this. We have sent out a video of how to do it, as well as the track to sing to. We're trying to get 180 voices strong, 10 times high, for singing of O Hanukkah. You do not need to have a good voice or perceive that you have a good voice. All are welcome, and we'll blend it together into a beautiful Sinai community initiative. We also have a clothing drive going on for School 45. Please bring new items for grades pre-K. Okay, thanks, Madeline. To the bin outside of Sally Constein's home until November 20th. The greatest need is for child size masks, gloves, socks, and underwear. And I think that's the signal that we are out of time. That is the end of my announcements. We now turn to Motzi and Kiddush.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri hagafen.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen.
Amen.
My, didn't that challah look tasty? All right. Just wanted to say thank you. As you can see, many, I think it's nearly 60 people contributed to this month's Leiled service. So thank you to everyone who did. Couldn't do it without you. And Lindsay has some more tidbits to share.
I echo the thanks that Susan just gave as well. A special thanks to J-Rock for their participation in two of our songs. And also we were extremely grateful to be able to use some of the tracks that Arena has recorded for a variety of things to sort of enhance our musical experience, which was lovely. We are going to move into our concluding song, which is Adon Olam. We will be doing the same thing that we did last time in terms of spotlighting people so that you can wave and say Shabbat Shalom. So if you don't want to be a part of that, now would be the time to turn off your camera. Alternatively, if your camera is off and you'd like to turn it on, feel free to do so. Just so everyone knows, our next Leiled service is January 30th. I think that's the Saturday. Yep. So if you'd like to be a part of that service, we look forward to seeing everybody then. Shabbat Shalom.
Adon Olam, Asher Malach, B'Terem Kol, Yetzir Nivra, V'Eit Nasach, V'Chef Sofo, Azay Melech Shemo Nivra, Adon Olam, Be'achare Kichot Hakol, Libado Yimlok Nora, Adon Olam, Behu Haya, Behu Lacham shilo lachabira adon olam v'hireishi 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 adon olam adon olam.
Adon